And I liked it, and I had it for weeks. And I couldn't think what to do with it. I was thinking, and one day, and my last act, this was during the summer too, funny enough, and I was out in the garden, and for some reason, you know, sometimes you get a tune come into your head. There's like a horrible tune, and you can't get rid of it. Well, this is the tune that came. And I couldn't get the bloody thing out of my head. And at the time, I was working with Pete Sinfield. We were writing lyrics for A Works Volume 1. And I said, you know, I've been looking for a song, some concept for a song with this guitar lick, and I cannot get this bloody Jingle Bells out of my head, you know. And he said, well, maybe it could be a Christmas song. Now, I'm not a big fan of those Christmas songs, personally, you know. I mean, I love Christmas, and I always have. And one of the things is, I remember Christmas as a child being, I mean, we were a very poor family, but it was always a time of sort of, there was a lot of goodwill around it. It was always goodwill on earth, peace, you know, peace on earth to all men, goodwill to all men. And, you know, as I grew older, I watched Christmas deteriorate into this sort of marketing campaign, and everyone got pressured the hell out of, you know, to come up with a load of Christmas presents. And it was a time of great stress. So instead of being a time of peace and love and forgiveness and all of that, it turned into a huge marketing, pressurized marketing campaign. So I said to Pete, maybe we could write a song that sort of laments, a serious commentary on that, you know. It was never written as a single. I know it's hard to believe that, but it wasn't. We wrote it as a serious album track about the way that Christmas had been eroded, the true spirit of Christmas had been eroded. And as a parallel, you know, when I talked to Pete about my childhood and everything, we decided that would be a good thing, is to use the child as the metaphor, as the vehicle to transport the song. This child, I believe in Father Christmas, you know. That sort of naive belief, but there's something good about it because there's goodwill attached to it. There's all the good human values in it. And so that was the idea. And that was the title, I Believe in Father Christmas. I wish you a hopeful Christmas. I wish you a brave new year. No. And I don't feel that.
Israelite, and I believed in Father.
society.